What's happening, guys? It's Nantos Commander with another episode of Pokemon of the Week. So no more formalities this time around, I'm just going to go straight into the details. So what have we got this time? This Pokemon was actually requested by... who was it again? Raichu0123, and he actually requested that I do Lapras. So Lapras is this week's Pokemon of the Week, so let's get into it. Now on appearance, this thing is awesome. I love this Pokemon's appearance. It's... I don't know what it exactly is, but it's like a combination of awesome and cute. I mean, it looks like the sort of thing that can be quite vicious if it gets quite mad, but like this, it just looks cute. I just love the smile and the eyes and the ear structure. And actually, as a bit of a side note, I want to say that the face kind of reminds me a little bit of Nidoqueen, and the ears remind me a bit of Gastrodon for some reason. Don't ask me what all that's about, I have no idea, I'm just going by what I think here. And also, it's actually kind of funny because when I was playing through 4th generation, I actually thought that perhaps maybe that Shellos and Gastrodon were two new pre-evolutions that would evolve into Lapras. Obviously, I came out to be wrong, it was only a thought that I had, but I actually thought that maybe Gastrodon may have evolved into Lapras, and maybe if it was, say, the pink version, they may have given us a new, you know, form of Lapras, like a different colour or something, but, you know, it turned out not to be, but just a little side note there. So, appearance, this thing is awesome. So taking a look at the stats page now. Lapras takes on the role that a lot of other water Pokemon take on, and that is the state that is known as a bulky water type. The only exception here is Lapras is part ice. So look at the stats. This thing's HP is fantastic. It's got a very high base HP. It can take it really nicely if it's a neutral or resistant, so anything that's neutral or resistant, Lapras can probably take very nicely, so base HP, a great start. Now, attack and special attack are actually decent. These don't do a ton of damage, but they are perfectly usable, and attack is something that I'll talk more about later, because there are ways to boost this stat. As a special attack, again, this is probably the main stat that Lapras can use, because I believe it has more special moves than it does physical, but I'll get onto that later. Speed is not very good at all, but as we all know, if you've got a Pokemon with low base speed, throw it onto a Trick Room. But in my opinion, the speed isn't actually a problem anyway, because as you can see, its special defense is also really good. It goes above 300, so combine that with the hit points, it takes hit quite nicely. Defense, I wish it was a little bit better, but it's not bad. I'm certainly not going to really pound on it. It is decent, yeah, with the big HP stats, so I won't harm on that too much, but it could have done being a little bit higher, but it could have been a lot worse, so that's it. So stats overall, they are pretty decent. Speed isn't really an issue because it's designed to be a bulky water ice type, so, you know, overall, they work. So taking a look at Lapras' abilities, now, Lapras' abilities are all excellent. Now, Shell Armor, it blocks critical hits, and that's really it. Probably its least useful ability, but if you've got a Pokemon that you really do not want to take critical hit with, then Lapras is definitely the way to go with Shell Armor. But if you want my better opinion, go with Water Absorb or Hydration. Water Absorb completely drains any water type attack Lapras will get hit with. So if you've got a Pokemon in a doubles tier that uses Surf, then you can use Water Absorb to completely absorb the attack and gain life. And when you combine that with the fact that Lapras has really good based HP, you're literally going to be taking, you know, water type attacks like a boss, because, well, you got water absorb, you won't be taking a hit basically, you'll be recovering your life, while at the same time you'll be making their water type attacks useless. Plus, if you've got a Pokemon out that's, say, weak to water, like a fire type or a rock type, then you can bring in Lapras, and unless it's got full HP, you'll literally drain the attack and get back your life. But if you want my honest opinion, I think Lapras' best ability is Hydration. Now, this is basically the Manaphy ability. If you have the rain out. At the end of every turn, hydration will heal any status problem that Lapras has. So this works great with rest, because rest recovers all of your HP, and as long as you're in the rain with hydration, you will recover your wake up right at the end of the turn. This is brilliant because you've got a high base HP to begin with, but to continuously recover it in the rain, it's not going to be nice for your opponents. The only options they've got are to either taunt you and stop you, or change the weather. These are pretty much the only ways you can stop it. Also, it's great for toxic stalling, as I've also put down in the support list. So look at the weaknesses and resistances. Weaknesses and resistances are not actually a nice side to Lapras. It's got 4 weaknesses and only 2 resistances. Now the electrical grass and rock I suppose are pretty standard, but the fighting weakness does not help either. All 4 of these weaknesses are actually quite commonly used. Electric is used a lot because of the likes of bulky water types and Gyarados, etc. Grass is also used a lot because of the likes of Gastrodon in the old days, Swampert and stuff like that. Rock, well, not too bothered about rock, because the only move I can think of that's rock that's used a lot is probably Stone Edge and maybe Rock Slide. But, you know, not too bothered about that weakness, but the fighting weakness is very nasty because a lot of fighting types are used in the higher metagames because of so many steel types around. So fighting type is a bit of a nasty weakness. Now if there was more resistances, it would be a bit nicer, but unfortunately she only has 2. Lapras only has water and ice, which is actually its own type as well. So unfortunately, weaknesses and resistances, an area that Lapras isn't so good on, but it's not overly bad. There is plenty of stuff that is neutral as well. Now you may be wondering, well, why have I listed Bulldoze if you've got Waterfall to hit Steel types? The reason I put Bulldoze down is because Waterfall actually hits Steel types just as hard as Bulldoze does, except Bulldoze comes with a secondary effect. It lowers the speed of any Pokemon that gets hit by it. So it's true that Waterfall would hit Steel types just as hard as Bulldoze would, but I think Bulldoze is a better choice because of that speed drop. It's always nice being able to find a way to lower your opponent's speed. Just don't use Bulldoze if you're using Lapras on a Trick Room team, because then you'll be helping your opponent because you'll be lowering their speed. As for everything else, Avalanche is good for a payback-like move. If Lapras gets hit by a move, Avalanche will do double the damage. Ice Shot is good for priority, getting rid of any Focus Sashes or Pokemon that are next to dead. And Return, I've just put Return down to hit anything for neutral damage. It works well on water types for the most part, so I would recommend you rest in using Return if you're wanting to run a physical set. Now for support, this is where Lapras really gets good. Curse and Dragon Dance will boost either your speed, you know, or lower your speed and raise your defense, and they boost all of your physical attacks. This is definitely the way to go if you want to make Lapras into a full-blown physical attacker. After a couple of curses, even moves like Return, Bulldoze and Waterfall will do a ton of damage. Dragon Dance is another reason why I'm not playing up too much on the speed stat. If you actually maximize the speed stat on Lapras, after a couple of Dragon Dances, you will have a solid speed stat. I think it's like 480, you know, which is pretty fast for a Lapras. So, yeah, and you'll have over 500 in attacking power as well. I would say that probably Curse is the better move, because Curse, if you're using it on a Trick Room team, it lowers your speed but raises your attack and defense, making Lapras take hits even better. But if you're looking for a speedy Lapras, then Dragon Dance is the better choice. As for everything else, it's mainly just for stalling purposes. Confuse Ray can cause trouble and be an annoyance to your opponent. You've got Toxic, Hail and all the other basic stuff, and 4th gen for Heal Bell. Your Heal Bell is good because it gets rid of any status problems on your entire team. Definitely a notable move for Lapras. As for Refresh, this is basically the downgraded version of Heal Bell. It'll heal Lapras's status conditions, but it's only really useful if you're not running the Hydration set. I was going to say Hydreigon then. But if you can get Heal Bell, get Heal Bell, but if you can't and you want something to recover life, then either run Hydration or Refresh. So that's pretty much all there is to say about the support and physical side. So taking a look at the special attacking side to Lapras, This is actually really good. It gets a load of special moves. If you want my opinion, Lapras is much better as a special attacker because it's got so many more moves to go with. Hydro Pump is good for power if you don't worry too much about accuracy. Surf, again, can be used on a doubles team to, say, heal your partner that might also have Water Absorb. Ice Beam, a standard stab attack. Blizzard can be used if you're running it under a hail team, because in the hail, Blizzard has 100% accuracy, and everything else is pretty standard. Now, why have I listed Psychic? Because it's actually quite funny, because, you know, just the other week I did the gaming article on Lapras. Well, Psychic, I put it down mainly because if you want something in specific you want to go for, likes of Toxicroak for instance, but as I said in the gaming article video, I would say that Psychic probably best avoided, but only use it if you're something in specific you want to target. But, you know, that's only if that specific thing is causing you trouble. Otherwise, don't bother with Psychic, run, say, Hydro Pump or Surf. Frost Breath is a good move because it always scores a critical hit, but you may be wondering, why run Frost Breath if you got Ice Beam? Frost Breath causes a critical hit, which ignores any boosts that your opponent may have. So if you have, say, got stockpile boosts or anything like that, or cosmic power, Frost Breath will ignore all of those and go straight for the critical hit. It is true that it would be roughly the same power as Ice Beam, or maybe a little bit less, but having that coverage over boosts is always a nice thing to have. So, also, as I've said in the notable uses, Thunder has 100% accuracy in the rain. So, taking a look at the downsides page now. Now, I've actually made a bit of a big mistake here on the downside, so, and that's what I say about Bulldoze. Now, ignore what I say about Bulldoze, that was a complete mistake on my part. I apologise for making that dumb mistake, but the Bulldoze only physical move for steel types, ignore that, because I completely forgot about Waterfall. I should have been paying more attention to what I was doing. I apologise for that, but Bulldoze, ignore that, it's a mistake on my part. As for the below average base defense, again, as I've said, it's only a small problem. I'm not going to hammer on it too much, and I've already talked about it, so let's move on to the last one. The more weaknesses and resistances is probably the biggest problem I have with Lapras. It's got a little too many weaknesses and not really many resistances to go along with it. Makes me happy that there isn't that many water ice types around. But again, this is probably the biggest query I have with Lapras, but I wouldn't say it's a gigantic problem. It just means you've got to be a little bit more careful when it comes to taking hits with Lapras. You just kind of have to experiment a little bit and see what Lapras can handle and what it simply cannot handle. So, taking a look at the rating. Now, for the rating, I give this thing a 9 out of 10. The reason I give it a 9 is because pretty much any problem that is with Lapras, except for the weaknesses and resistances, have some way of being dealt with. For the average defense, there's Curse to boost it up to good levels, and it has an amazing amount of support moves, and does a good amount of special moves to go with it as well. So when you calculate all this, you have got yourself a pretty solid water ice type as a war. So all I'm gonna say now, hope you like this video, and yeah, I'm just running out of words here, so I'll end the video right now.